All right, everyone, let's move into Crescent Moon Pose.
Phew, I'm ready for a smoothie after this.
Me too.
I second that. So, Beth, how have things been going at work?
Great, actually. I just came out to my coworkers last week.
Wow, that's great. How do you feel?
Honestly, I feel like a huge weight is lifted off of my shoulders. I'm much happier and feel way more like myself.
That is so great, Beth. I'm really happy for you, and it's great you work somewhere that is inclusive and accepting of you.
Thanks, Mary.
Yeah, that's great.
Okay, now let's finish it up with the tree pose. There is just one thing.
What?
Well, I came out as pansexual, and a lot of people at work were questioning what that meant. Everyone was really nice, but a few of my coworkers are calling me bisexual, and some that I've tried to correct think it's the same thing.
But they are pretty much the same thing, though, aren't they?
Okay, great job, everyone! Now move into meditation pose and cool down. They're similar, yes, but not the same thing. It is a common mistake that many people make. The prefix pan means all. Pansexuality is the romantic or emotional attractions towards people regardless of their sex or gender identity. Pansexuals more so don't see gender when it comes to falling in love. It's about the person. Bisexuality is when someone is attracted to more than one sex or gender. The important distinction is that more than one isn't the same as all.
That makes more sense. I could see why both identities are mixed up so often.
Definitely. I think many people look at the standard LGBTQ acronym and think the B is a singular identity, when really, that is just the top of a larger community, the B plus community.
Exactly. Within the B umbrella falls many other sexual orientations and preferences that are not as commonly discussed.
Right. And there seems to be this stigma around being attracted to more than one gender, whether you're bisexual, pansexual, or anything in between.
I mean, it's not new, both pansexuality and bisexuality. Discussion around it dates back to the late 1800s. But it has been talked about more in the media, and I think it is a great step forward for us. There is still a lot to be debunked about the identities, but I'm really excited for the future.
I'm excited too. And I'll be more cautious of how I approach my coworkers and friends who identify as bisexual or pansexual.
That's great, Luke. It's important to respect someone and not discredit their sexual identity just because they're with a certain gender. Beth is still pansexual if she's with a woman, and she's still pansexual if she's with a man.
Right, and I think that is a lesson that needs to be understood by those outside the LGBTQ community and within it.
Agreed. We can't grow if we don't talk about it. I'll try to start educating my coworkers about the B+ community. Now, who's ready for a smoothie?
Me!
Me!